I'm Marc Airhart. As Texans look for ways to prepare for the next big drought, scientists at the University of Texas at Austin are looking to the past for answers. They're trying to understand what triggers droughts and what turns an ordinary drought into a record-busting mega-drought. One of the most exciting new research sites is West Cave Preserve, about an hour out of Austin. The cave is special because it acts like a natural thermometer, recording changes in temperatures going back through time. I visited the cave with graduate student Richard Casteel.
The temperature in the cave varies with the seasonal temperature, so it's hotter in the summer in here and it's cooler in the wintertime, where in a lot of other caves, the cave air temperature is pretty much constant.
That makes this one of the few caves in Texas where rocky formations called stalagmites could possibly record real outside air temperatures.
So it's okay to step pretty much anywhere?
Well, just don't step on anything like it looks nice, I guess, or that looks like,
okay.
Yeah, so step on just like the dirt, I would say, like nothing white, that would be bad.
Okay.
Now, stalagmites, you'll remember from high school science class, are rocky blobs on the floors of caves that are produced by the drip, drip, drip of water from the ceiling. Watching Casteel, it sometimes feels like he's working in geologic time.
It's kind of like watching grass grow.
Yeah. Yeah, so one drop in 41.2 seconds.
Over time, minerals such as calcite get deposited layer by layer, forming stalagmites. Depending on what temperature it is in the cave at the time a layer forms, a different mix of minerals and chemicals are left behind. For Casteel, the goal is to drill cores from these stalagmites and read the layers like tree rings.
What I'm interested in is water resources. I like living in Austin, and I want to live here for a while, and we live in a drought-prone area. Our population's growing, so we need to figure out a way to manage our water resources. And one way of doing that is by looking in the paleoclimate record to see what droughts were like in the past, so we can maybe make some assumptions as to what they'll be like in the future and plan for that.
The key to unlocking past temperatures recorded in stalagmites is to observe how temperatures today influence the newest layers that are forming. So each month, Casteel visits the cave and collects water dripping from the ceiling and the minerals that form on glass plates he leaves sitting on top of stalagmites. Back in the lab, he uses some sophisticated tools to measure things like barium and strontium ions and oxygen isotopes.
And so what that allows us to do is kind of use the modern system as an analog for what was going on in the past. And so if we see the same patterns in the past that we've seen in the modern system, then we can be more sure of our assumptions about past climate.
Tree ring studies conducted by Casteel, his advisor Jay Banner, and others have revealed a series of severe droughts in this region going back hundreds of years. But tree rings record the combined effects of both temperature and rainfall. Stalagmites, on the other hand, record temperature by itself. Casteel says putting both types of records side by side might reveal what triggered the droughts and what sustained them.
So if we can also compare the stalagmite temperature record to the tree cores, we can use stalagmites for temperature and look at when there were droughts in the tree core record, what the temperatures were like. And so then we can maybe make an assumption that if there was a drought and it was really hot, we could say it was driven by heat perhaps. And if there's a drought and the temperatures were kind of cool, we could say, well, it was driven mostly by lack of rainfall.
Our thanks to Richard Casteel. For the University of Texas at Austin, I'm Marc Airhart.